Cut those tapes. Turn it the other way. Yeah, that's right. Be careful.
There.
Alright. Let's put that down. And be careful. Yep.
I have gaming pieces.
Take the stuff out.
Alright.
Take the stuff out. Make sure you put it where you gotta use, because you're gonna have to reuse this stuff again. You can just take the whole thing and set off to the side. Okay. Take your motherboard out the box. Be careful with it now. Okay. So you can see what you're doing. You're gonna take it out the box, take it out the wrapping. Be careful with it. The bottom is kind of sharp, so just be careful. Alright, so here is where your CPU goes.
Mm.
Okay, that's where your memory goes.
Mm.
These are your SSD NVMe drives. You have two of them, and they can go here or here. And I need to read your manual, because one of these is faster than the other. In order to put the processor in here, you have to lift up on this metal tab. So you're going to push it to the right and lift it up.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Push it to the right. Don't be afraid of it. You might have to lift it up all the way. All the way. There you go. All the way.
Mm.
Okay. Now, this is what you don't touch either. You don't touch the inside, because that's where the processor is going to sit. If you touch that, you will damage it. The computer's pretty much dead. Okay?
Mm.
Now, if you look to the corner, you see where there's a little dot right there?
Mm-hmm.
That's where, if you look on the processor, see these little dots here?
Mm-hmm.
Alright? See that little triangle?
Mm-hmm.
That's where it's going to go, where that dot is.
Mm.
Okay? So you want to take it out. Get a good grip on it. Don't drop it in there. Just place it in there. But don't drop it. Make sure you get it in there. Don't press down. Put it dead center. You will feel it slide right in there.
Mm, I got it in.
You got it in. Okay, good job. Good job.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now what do you think you do?
Close it.
Okay. Close it. Hold on. All right. Try it again. There you go. Now, hold on. When you press, it's going to be a little tight. Okay, and that's fine. That's normal. When you do that, you're going to slide it back up on that box. This little black portion will pop up. Okay. Slide it under there. Keep going. You're all right. There you go. Now you take that. Keep that. That's part of your warranty. You want to do the SSDs?
Yes.
Okay, SSD.
Got it.
That easy? That's your SSD.
Something's still in here.
Oh, it's just packaging. Oh. So you can just put the rest of that away. Open up the other one.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, now, handle those delicate too, because they can be kind of fragile. You can take it out that, yeah, take it out of that, and just set them to the side. One's going to go here, and the other's going to go here. So you have to take this cover. This is a thermal cover for the SSD. You need a screwdriver.
Nope, it's it.
Okay. It's magnetized, so it holds on to the screw.
Yay!
Mm-hmm. So, let them hold that screw. We got to make sure we do not lose the screw. Gonna put it over here. Right there.
We should put it like this so it does not roll away.
Battery's gone.
Hmm. All right, well, keep going. Don't stop. That was fast.
And the other one, right here. Now I'm going to take this off.
You can take, just, first of all, look at where it's orientated. Look at how it's orientated on the motherboard, because when you go to put it back on, you're going to need to know.
The silver side is closest to these.
Okay, so the silver side is on the bottom, though. So it goes, the lines come in and this goes down, because it, see, it lines up with the hashtag on the motherboard.
Yes.
Okay.
Let's take it off.
Okay. Take that out the package, be careful. Pull it up. It's okay. Pull it up. There you go. You can flip it over so it's... Yeah. Yep. Pick it up. It's not as fragile as the processor was. Alright. So now, you see this little notch right here?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to line up with the notch that's on there. Those gold teeth. You're going to kind of wiggle it in there. Oh. Yep. You got to push it in there. Kind of, when you do it at an angle like this. Hold it like this. Hold it at this end. Hold it at this end. Where my thumb is. Yeah. Now you kind of wiggle it in until you see. There you go.
Mm.
That's it.
Okay.
That's how you install it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Now remember that screw?
Yes.
Not that one.
This one?
Well, both of those. We need to take the thermal cover, and we're gonna put the thermal cover back on it.
This,
I'm gonna take the
this.
That way. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna take the thermal paste off.
Mm.
All right. And you're gonna put that.
Wait, leave this stuff on.
Yeah, leave that on because that's part of a thermal pad. And make sure you get the orientation right. That's right.
Yep.
And just set it on top. Make sure you get it lined up right.
I don't know if that's on right.
Look for the screw holes. Screwdriver. Screw on your screwdriver.
Hmm.
Or if you want to, however you want to do it. Good job. All right. Now,
the big one,
that's the standoff. This is called the standoff. You see they got numbers on them? What's that say?
2242.
What does this one say?
2260.
And what's the next one?
2280.
If you want to know which one it goes in, you have to check your box. Your box will tell you which size it is. Take your standoff. You're going to screw it into which slot?
2280.
All right. So you're going to screw it in. You don't need a screwdriver. Just finger tighten it. It can be a little tricky to get in there, but it's, yep, still in there. And okay, now you can take your SSD drive and put it back in there. There you go. Good job. Now you take the screw, that small screw. You may have to use, you're going to have to use a screwdriver. I'm don't know if you can get it started, but if you can, that's good for you.
Yep, I got it in the tiniest little bit. Wait. Okay, I was able to screw it in.
Okay. Screwdriver, right now. You got it?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and start taking that out. See the tab take out? There you go. Pull it out. It's a lot of stuff in there, so. Yep, take that out. That's your, some of your, that's a fan. That other boss that you took out the first time on your tools. It's kind of heavy, so. Just take that. Grab it by. Mm-hmm. You should hold on to it because it's kind of heavy.
It's not heavy, just hard to pull out.
Now try to pull it out.
Okay.
Now, what do you think that part is called that you have in your hand? What does it look like? It looks like a part of a car, which is what?
Radiator.
That's what it is. It's the radiator.
Yes.
Okay. So you can set that down, or you can put it back in a box. It don't matter. Put it back in the box. You can. Put it upside, it'll be easy, upside down, yeah. See, it'll be easy for you. Okay, so we'll take this, pull this off to the side, bring this over. It's where all your tools are. No, not your fan, that white box, that's where all your tools are. Okay, take everything out of there. Sure, you take everything. It comes with its own screwdriver. Mm-hmm. And it's already magnetized, so we don't need to magnetize it. I'm going to take this and open it up. Oh, we need to get the instructions out of here. You're going to need these instructions as well. Those are your brackets. These are brackets for your fan. These are for the actual radiator. These are your screws. That's called thermal compound or thermal paste for that you put on the processor that you need for the cooler.
Okay.
Okay. All right, and that's your back plate for your cooler. Now, to find out what goes that you're going to use and what you're not going to use, open that up. You need to figure out what screws, after you put the back plate on, you need to figure out what screws go to what. Now, if you look, one says Intel, one says AMD. Now, what system do you think you're building?
Intel.
Right. These are the different numbers for the socket, which is where you just put the processor. Now, in order to find out what socket you have, you can look at your box of your processor. Your box, look on the front of your box right here. Do you see a number that matches up with any of these numbers on the box? Anybody down here?
1151.
Okay, so now you know that the socket is 1151, and you're looking, whatever says 1151 here, that's how you're going to use your back plate to screw. Now, hold it almost exactly how it's pictured. You see the holes? There are two holes. There you go. Now, you see these holes right here? You see the three holes? The three holes. Which hole do you put the screw in when you get ready to mount it? To know that, you got to figure out what number your socket is. Do you see the number of the socket that we just mentioned? What was the socket number?
1151.
Where's the 1151 at? It's probably going to say, if it says 115X, it's X means what? X can mean what?
One,
two, three, four, doesn't matter. X is an open number. So,
okay.
1150X or 115X means the same as 1151. So which hole is the electrical one going to go in?
This one.
That's the one that's going to, yes, that's the one. Now that you've established which holes they're going, you need to find the screws to go with it. So go ahead and put your back plate down and look on your gram and figure out which screws that it's going to take. So this is step one. These are your numbers, step one, step two, step three, step four, so on and so forth. Now that you figure out which, another thing. What do you think the rubber is going to go when you place it on the back plate of the motherboard?
On the bottom.
Right, it's going to go, this rubber piece is going to go up against the motherboard because it's rubber and you want to protect it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, look at number two and find out what screws that they say to use.
This big one.
The big one?
The big ones.
Okay, so take out, put that back down. So take out the big ones and you should be taking how many out?
Four.
Now we're going to put on the back plate. Actually, yeah, we're going to put on the back plate. Okay. Nope. But you're going to put this on first. Put it on now. Make sure it covers those three holes. Line it up right. Okay, it's not going to stick, obviously. Alright, so I said this takes a two-handed job. Now, those go on the other side of the motherboard.
These?
Yep, they go on the other side. But you got to line. You gotta line them up with those holes.
Okay, now.
What's the next step? You got step three, we just did that. What's step four?
The fluid thing.
You're missing one. Step three was the one that we just missed.
The bracket.
Okay, the bracket. So, alright. Now, you have two sets of brackets. Okay. Now, which brackets are you going to use? On your diagram, which brackets are you going to use?
The short ones.
Okay, then you can put these back in the box because you know you won't be using them. How does it say you put them on now?
Screws. The screws.
Okay.
Screws to fit inside of the other thing.
Okay, so what screws do you need? You see what screws you need? Show you the type of screws that you need.
The small ones.
Okay. How many do you need?
Four.
Alright. Your instructions say, there's another one of those like this here. Where does it say the 11.5x screw goes? You see where it says?
The middle.
Okay. When you put these on, that's what this diagram here is saying. You see how this raised?
Mm-hmm.
That's how you want to put it. You don't want to put it this way because it, see how it's low now instead of high? Okay. Now, which way are you going to put them on the motherboard?
Mm-hmm.
Which way does it say those brackets go?
Mm-hmm.
So which way it says to go?
This way.
Okay. Okay. You just rest it on top. You gotta go right on top. Yep, right on top of those little screws. Couple of turns on where we need to set it. Okay, that should be right. So you can go ahead and tighten those down. Turns just to keep make sure it doesn't go anywhere. Put it on the end of your screwdriver. Put it on the end of your screwdriver because it's magnetized. There you go. Now I drill it on now. It'll be easier. See that? Makes it easier. What do you think is next?
I don't know.
You are going to need some gloves for this one. When you put some on, just put like a pea size. You ain't got to put a whole lot. Just put a little pea size of it. Come on, come down so you don't spread that right above. There you go. That's good. Right, that's good.
This?
Yep, that's good. Put the cap back on it.
Do I just spread it on it?
When you spread it, yep, you're gonna go make sure it just covers everything. So going like a square on all sides. Yep. Just stay on the top. Don't go too far off the sides. Might need a little more. Keep going. Cover up. So you don't see no more of that silver. I'm probably going to have to put a little more.
I don't see it.
There. Might be enough. What do you think is next?
The radiator.
Screws right here. Go right over these two holes right here. See them?
Mm-hmm.
So just place it over there. Place it over them holes. It's kind of heavy. So do your best. I'm going to hold this so you don't. It's not going to fit perfect, but just get it to where those holes are on there.
Mm-hmm.
Where those screws are on the hole. Alright, and then you take your screwdriver and you start the drilling. Now, do one side a few times and then jump to the other side.
Right here.
Few times there and then switch. You want to keep alternating until they all tight. But keep alternating between because what happens is it'll go on evenly. If you screw one side down the other, if you screw one side down and not do the other one, it'll probably come out a little uneven and you might have issues. So you always want to alternate. The brackets are the same, so there's no difference. They just give you extra back because you can actually attach two fans of this coolant stuff. But they only give you one fan. That's all you're going to need.
There's no fan clip to the fan.
Right. So you're going to take, you only need two.
I know.
Okay. Which side do you install it on? Whenever you see.
On this side.
Okay.
Over there.
You got it. So, whenever you see a fan that has this bracket here, because you notice this one has this bracket here, the other side does not. So whenever you see this bracket, that means that it goes towards the back. It's the exhaust. This is the intake and this is the exhaust. So you're gonna have to, you were right. You gotta push it in there though. When you put them in there, you gotta press this right in there. You'll feel it click right in there. There you go. And do the other one.
On the other side.
Nope, the other way. You had it right the first time. You just gotta... Yeah. Keep going. Just keep going. There you go. Okay, you want to get it. You see where these little, you see where this little groove is right here? And on the side. So that's where you want the fan to go. So you just put it right up against it. Make sure these are right in there. Okay, now you have to take these. It might be a little tough to do. But you got to pull this all the way to this groove right here. Right into the groove. See if you can pull it. It ain't gonna hurt it, so just pull it. Pull it. There you go.
Good job.
Okay, other side. We gotta make sure that we get this.
Alright.
Oh, wait.
Got it. Is it there? Nope, it's not there. There we go. Good job. All right. Now, we need to change out this cord. Because this cord is more like a wire. And if this wire heating, when the heat hits this wire, it'll fray it. And then if it gets loose in here, it could damage your computer. So you need to take this off. We need to get one of these and put on now.
Make it a little wider.
So what color do you want to put? I don't care what color you choose.
Red.
Get a red one out of there. All right. So choose a red one. Now you're going to... The way this goes on is... If you look at it, this here is going to go in like a snake almost, just like that. Okay? So you want to take this, wrap it up, keep pushing it. You'll feel it start locking. Just tighten it off. There you go. That's good. Now you got to click off this. It's called the pigtail. You got to clip that off. So try to get as close to this as you can and cut that off. There you go. See where these little, see where this hole is?
Mm-hmm.
See what that next thing is?
Mm-hmm.
Am I in the shot?
What does it say right behind that? You see some words? What do they say?
CPU fan.
What do you think this is?
CPU fan.
Okay. Now, the orientation. Do you see anything different on here? See those notches? You see where it's a notch on this board at?
Yes.
They're going to line up with each other.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to... Hold on.
Like this?
Yeah, like that. So you put it on just like that. Installed the CPU cooler.
Yay.
All right, good job.
Now, guess what you've done with your motherboard?
Hmm.
You've almost prepped it. Guess what's next?
Hmm.
What do you think is next?
Let's put this
memory. Before you install your memory, You can install it. We're installing two, so you can use either the black on the black or the gray on the gray. Don't do gray black because it's going to mess things up. So you want to put them in the gray or you want to put them in the black?
Black.
Black? Okay. See this notch? Hold on.
Mm-hmm.
See this notch?
Mm-hmm.
Push it towards me. Alright. Do the other one.
This one?
Mm-hmm. Alright. These don't move. Okay. To know which way the memory goes on. See that little notch?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to line it up with the notch right here. So you just kind of put it on there to make sure if it's not right. And you got to put it inside. Yeah, you can start there. That's fine. If you want to start this side. Put it right in that slot right there.
It fit.
Does it line up? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to push it down one side. You do one side and then the other side. And you should hear clicks. It's a little tough. So do the push on these corners. You should hear clicks. There you go. It's kind of tough because you're in the back and it's kind of hard to see. Do left and right first or right and left. There you go.
You know what? I think I'm going to make a mask for us to hang out.
Hold on. That might be it.
Yep, it's in.
It's in there. This clip is in there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sometimes it doesn't always click. You've prepped your motherboard. All right. Good job. Alright.
There's another fan.
Three fans. Two in the front, one in the back.
Ah!
In the front, one in the
back.
We need to unscrew these. And these usually you can unscrew with your thumbs. Okay. And we're going to take this off.
Just now.
Okay, you see this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's what you pull to take the side of the case off with. Just pull it back towards you. Don't pull it out, but pull it towards you.
Towards?
Yep, there you go. Okay, pull that, put that, should be, put that up. There you go.
Screws.
All right. These are for hard drives and SSD drive storage, but if we have to give you a hard drive, we'll get you one. This is what you'll need. Put it down. Do you see any screws that look like Saturn? They got a ring around them, kind of resemble Saturn.
Mm-hmm.
Where?
Like this.
Okay. Those are the ones we need.
Okay.
You see where the standoffs are inside the case? Yep. How many?
Six.
Got six? You sure?
I think. No. Nine.
There you go. You got nine. These are what's called your front umbilicals. What does that say?
Audio.
Okay. That's your audio USB. The audio cable. And this one probably doesn't say anything. Sure, but it probably doesn't. This is your USB 3.1.
Okay.
Okay, and these are for your power, reset, and LED, so you see what it says?
Reset switch.
Reset switch. And
power switch, power LED, minus power LED plus.
The minus is also means what?
Less.
Or when it comes to electricity.
Off.
When it comes to electricity, plus is what?
Positive.
And what's the minus?
Negative.
There you go. You got it. Before we put the motherboard in, we need to put in the I.O. shield for that back plate. See that little silver thing here? That. Take that. Yeah, be careful. These edges can be very sharp. Edge can be very sharp. Now, which side do you think is the side that faces you?
This
right,
side.
Because first of all, you have pictures on here that show you HDMI, and then this side, if you feel it picking you, or if it pokes you, you know that side goes on the inside of the computer. This part can be a little tricky because you have to use a lot of force in order to get it in the case. Okay, where do you think it goes?
Where do I think?
That?
Here.
Right, but you gotta do it from the inside. So when you put it on the inside, you wanna make sure that you have to press it in there. You have to get it in there, you have to press it until you start hearing a series of clicks. It's gonna be probably one of the trickiest and toughest for a newbie. Now it may not always click, or it may not always make a sound, but you wanna start. You want to kind of start at the bottom first. You have to push real kind of tough. Just push on the edges of it. There you go. There you go.
Okay, I think that's all.
Should be a lot more than that. But it might be.
Yep, I think that's it.
You usually can feel if it's flush if you run your finger around it. Yeah, actually went in pretty good. There it goes up. It still looks a little uneven here. I can still see where it's.
Oh yeah, it's not in yet.
Whenever you're putting this in also, be mindful of what holes are where. These round holes, these speaker holes, they always go on the bottom. They don't go up at the top. Your mouse, keyboard, always go on the top.
Mic. Yay.
Always go.
Microphone.
Yep, you got a microphone you can plug in, speakers. You're good.
Mouse/keyboard.
Mm-hmm. Grab the motherboard. Now you can grab the motherboard by this. Pick it up like this now. So you want to come over and grab that. You hold on to it kind of tightly. Now don't drop it.
Like, is it going?
Hold on. You got to match things up. So look at the back of you. Turn it around. Turn it around. Turn around this way. What do you see?
Three. Oh, wait!
Mm-hmm.
Like this.
There you go. There you go. You're right. You want to hold it by the heat sink. Hold it by this. There you go. Just hold on to it. Go ahead. Start putting it in there. You're going to just line it up. It's kind of tricky because it's...
No, I see it on this side.
There it goes. Boom, it just set.
Yeah.
Good, it just set. All right. Get those screws out that look like Saturn. How many do you need?
Nine.
All right, get your nine.
Right here?
Yep, wherever you see a hole.
Uh-oh.
Magnetize it. What you need magnetizing it for?
So it won't stick, so then I can easily fit it in there. Screw it in something, then it'll... Is that it?
Nope. Still got ones on the top.
Oh yeah.
That's him. Yeah, you want me to turn it?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you got it.
Yeah.
You want me to turn it? Or you got it?
Yes, turn it.
Turn it this way so you can... Need to connect the fans.
Yay!
I'm at different zip ties. Okay. You want a different color or you want that black?
Black will be fine.
Okay.
No.
legs and arms up top. Okay, back fan is connected.
Now what next?
What is next? We still gotta connect the front umbilicals and what's your power, your reset, USBs. I got USB 3, is no one, two. And the fans, so we'll connect these two fans.
Now I want to plug in. That's it.
So you got this cable.
I know.
Okay. It says CPU, so look for something that says CPU. See it? That's the one that's all the way in the back.
This one right here?
It's got a,
yeah, hold on. See where it says okay, CPU, so you can go in one of those. Now the next thing we gotta plug in is your graphics card. So this is called a 6+8 pin graphics card. So you need to find your look in your cables there. And you're gonna find a should say PCIe.
Oh.
You're gonna have.
Wait, I think I left
that.
How much support? Or you might have put it back.
I may have put it back because I was trying to find.
Yeah, I have actually it. Go on.
Okay. Feed that through here.
You gotta plug in the second one.
Hold on. That's not the second one. This is what you plug into the graphics card. Just pull them both through there. Who? Be careful, that graphics card is there.
Uh-oh. Okay, I got it.
Okay, hold on, you got one more. You got one more to plug into the power supply. Alright, I feed that through too. Now, we have to find out where this is going to go inside the computer. Alright, so there's a clip right here. It's a locking clip. You want to make sure it's in the open position. Right now, that's closed. That's open. Okay? Before you do it, line it up. Line the graphics card up. Don't push it, but just line it up because you need to see where is it going to go with these two brackets. See the black? See where it lines up in these back brackets back here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you know it's gonna go, you need to take out the first two.
These two?
Yes, those two. They're slot covers for PCIe devices, for expansion covers, for expanded devices like graphics cards and capture cards, things of that nature. You always want to make sure you save those because if you decide you want to change something or you want to put them back, you can do that. Alright. Now you want to take your graphics card. You want to try to make sure you get, bring it out, Bring it out. You see these points right here? These 2 points, you want to make sure they go right inside these slots. That's on the side of the motherboard. And when you get it lined, those holes lined up, you should be good to push it on in. Let me hold this because it will slide. You line it up, you're just going to... You should hear it go, it'll go like snap. Make sure you don't go at an angle. Keep it straight and push it straight on. There you go.
I got graphics.
You got a graphics card. There you go.
And it fit perfectly.
Yep, it went right in those holes. Good job. Now, the same screws that you took out,
put
them back in to secure it. Other way. Now, all that's left to do is connect these cables. You want to kind of start on the far end and work your way over because you got more room on this side and this side. Now, these split. If you see like that little notch, push up, push it forward.
Oh.
Now you got
six
and eight. And then we'll cable manage the rest of that.
What do we do with this?
We'll cable tie that. Since it's not being used.
Now is it done?
We are done. The same, almost the same place that your graphics card
is set right for. There.
There should be one.
I see it right under there.
Usually you can put a short one and a long one, but you can't do a long one and a short one.
Yeah.
So let's see how it goes. Yep, it'll work. Good.
Yay!
Is running. Good job.